Welcome to Revive Kids. Today, we have some exciting things in store for you. I hope you enjoyed the episode.
Hi, Revive Kids. I'm Anaya. Today, we are going to learn about God's armor. Can you see what I'm wearing? Does it look cool? This is the belt of truth and the breastplate of righteousness. Now let's jump straight into it.
Over the next couple of episodes, we're going to talk all about God's armor. What do you think soldiers needed armor for? Well, it was to protect them in battle. In Jesus' time, there were a lot of Roman soldiers walking around. Do you think it would have been very smart or safe for them to walk around just with a long tunic or, you know, in our days, just t-shirt and jeans? Not really. They would have a big sword, they would have a shield, they would have a breastplate. All these things protected them if they were in battle. Can you imagine if an arrow came their way? They could put their shield on to block the arrow and protect them. Well, it talks in Ephesians about God's armor and how putting on God's armor protects us. In Ephesians 6 verse 11, it says, "Put on the full armor of God so that you can take your stand against the devil's schemes." See, when we talk about this armor, we're not always talking about going into physical fights. We're not putting God's special sword on that we carry to school. That wouldn't be very safe. But what we are talking about is things like the belt of truth and the breastplate of righteousness. See, with something like the belt of truth, we can put this on. Now, you might think of a belt and say, well, a belt isn't that important, is it? It can hold your pants up, and is that it? Well, first of all, that is pretty important, because can you imagine a soldier's pants falling down in a battle? That wouldn't be too fun. Another thing is Romans at the time would put their sword on their belt. So having a belt was really important. We talk about the belt of truth in terms of God's armor. The belt of truth means God's word, knowing what God's word says. And having that as a belt means that we have a really strong foundation. So when we're talking about the belt of truth, we talk about having a strong foundation in God's word. And having that can help us really no matter what anything comes through. And that's why it's the first part of the armor. It's the most important thing to start off with. It's a really important foundation. Now, we also have the breastplate of righteousness. With a breastplate, this would protect the heart and the lungs of a soldier. So this is really important. Your heart, you need that to live. You need that to do anything, really. So in terms of the breastplate of righteousness, well, righteousness is all about obeying God's word and his commands. So when you're listening to what the Bible says and following those commands, it can protect us when things come our way. You see, by having our lives and living our lives in righteousness, when temptation comes our way or someone does something mean to us, living in righteousness can help protect our heart. It can help us stand firm in God and stand firm in God's commandments. So by having the armor of God on us, we can be protected from when hard things come our way or when the devil tries to trick us or tempt us. It's really important to learn about God's armor and make sure we are equipped with it for every day.
Whoa, what isn't that a good lesson? The breastplate protects my heart and the belt is my strong foundation. Now it's time for the Bible story.
Jesus is tempted in the wilderness. Jesus was led by the Holy Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted by the devil. After fasting for 40 days and 40 nights, he was hungry. The tempter came to him and said, "If you are the Son of God, tell these stones to become bread." Jesus answered, "It is written, man should not live on bread alone, but on every word that comes from the mouth of God." Then the devil took him to Jerusalem and set him on the highest point of the temple. "If you are the Son of God," he said, "throw yourself down, for it is written, he will command his angels concerning you, and they will lift you up into their hands so that you will not strike your foot against a stone." Jesus answered him, "It is also written, 'Do not put the Lord your God to the test.'" The devil took Jesus to a very high mountain and showed him all the kingdoms of the world and their splendor. "All this I will give you," he said, "if you will bow down and worship me." Jesus said, "Away from me, Satan, for it is written, 'Worship the Lord your God and serve him only.'" Then the devil left Jesus, and the angels came and attended him.
Wow, what an amazing Bible story. Boys and girls, today we have learnt so many amazing things in the episode, but there are two main points that I want you to take away. The first is the belt of truth. You see, today we learnt about how the belt of truth helps keep things up, but it is also our strong foundation. As Christians, when we wear our belt of truth, we remember what is right. We remember what is in God's word. How do we know this? We must read the Bible, spend time with God, so that we know what is true. You see, in the Bible story today, we learned about how Jesus was able to flee the enemy's temptations in the wilderness. He didn't get tempted. He was not tricked by the enemy. And do you know why? That is because Jesus knew God's word. He had his belt of truth on. So as Christians, don't forget to put your belt of truth on so that we are able to discern what is God's way and what is not God's way. Number two, breastplate of righteousness. You see, God wants us to live a righteous life. Today, we learnt about this. We learnt about how the breastplate can protect us. You see, God looks at our heart. He wants our heart to be free from sin, things that hold us back, maybe unforgiveness, maybe anger. He wants our heart to be free from that. And that's when we can imagine wearing the breastplate of righteousness to protect our heart so that we can live God's way, so that we can make the right choices in life. Just like the Roman soldiers, when they wore this to protect their valuable parts like their hearts and their lungs, as Christians, we need to be wearing God's armor, wearing the breastplate of righteousness to protect our hearts. Thank you for watching. We hope you enjoyed this episode. Now, if you want the latest updates or to watch past episodes, please make sure you're following us on social media or subscribe to our YouTube channel. Have a great day.